Tonight we'll be seeing a Division 1 versus Division 2 clash, with both managers looking for them. We'll also be seeing Sean Ruach as main referee, and Good Sammy as the second official at linesman. Team getting ready to walk out now to the tune of Z Cars. As we see the teams come out now towards the halfway line. Got the lineups for you here. Goal, we actually have Spyro's keeper David Longley in goal for SCFC, that is. At centre back is Imagine Zagari, very big hard man. And then centre mid, French Fries God, Elias, and then two strikers probably, XDNO and Foyer, who has changed username now to Master Deacons after previously being Stambound as well. Now for the Guildley Town lineup, it's planning in goal on the Black Rose, Shane Frost, also known as IA Shady by his current username, OliS20, Philip Meehan, Samu Frost and Silent Rose. Captain's being called up now for the coin toss. Also on the subs bench for Guildley. He's on loan tonight, it's Determined Forter, former Guildley player, but now playing for Congler in Division 2. And as their car stops, both teams prepare for the battle ahead of them. And it's going to be Samu Frost, lifelong Celtic fan, to take the kick. The referee sounds as a beep. And apparently there's a dead player on the pitch. And can finally confirm that Zed Altesca has arrived, big boss in the midfield. And we switch to an 8v8. And we're off now, underway. It's Philip Neame on the ball. Looks to play it up. Shay Frost battling out with French, but he always going to win that battle. It's Shay Frost again. Now to Wally S20. And Tess grabs hold of the ball, moves back into midfield. And French gets that clear. Determined intercept. Here's Samu. Takes a heavy touch. And French gets the better of him. Alfie now plays it back to the trialist keeper, David Langley. Plays it forward now to Elias. Bit of confusion here between Elias and Freddy Bicarman. Now we've got top to four, yeah. He's onside, I think. Oh, that thing that goes with the keeper. Xdino was onside. Saved by Connie. Bunted up by Connie. And very big hammer man showed. Collect easily. Back to the keeper, Paul. Now David Langley to try this keeper out to Alfie. That one's gone off for a throw-in. And it's launched up to Xdino. He plays a lovely ball into the four, yeah. And he's gone past an offender there, Philip Mee. And it's 1-0 SCFC. Xdino with the assist. And four-year finishes beautifully. What a play. And Sammy Frost takes the last kick off. Oh, white to Wally. Sorry, that's the same. Over the top, Tesk on side. And that one goes on for the corner kick. Corners whips into the middle. Loads of power on it, but no one can latch onto it unless Ollie can now. He's on well to get past very big arm man, but French daddy's up at SCFC. Now Elias, lovely skill to get around Tesk. And Ollie hustles through. He's still got it, Ollie. Could get a cross in now, and very big arm man deals with it. Excellent. Launched in by Ollie. Here's Tesk. Still Tesk now. French fries tackle. And now Elias plays a long ball to Fourier. Determined trying to get back now from left wing. Fourier crosses it in. Oh no, he doesn't. Does well to cut inside. And that sends it away. Oh, bit of lag there. Good aim. Connie collect. That's a poor kick from Connie. Gonna go well for the... Now here's for you. Looking to play a ball over the top. To Elias. Just about misses XD, you know. Elias has a goal and saved by Connolly. Heads it up by very big hard man. Mark Rose will look to get this cleared over Elias. As he does, and Elias has just been dragged by the ball there. It's going to mean a lot to SCFC, but they've got a lot of men forward now. Oh yes, 20, now into Tesk. Tess does well to drop back into midfield. Elias tackles him, no. And it's XD, no. is block, still block. And no test. Ready big hard man clears the danger, but it goes straight back to determined. Few Guildley town players battling for the winning winner throwing. Now Philip Neen looking to launch it into the box. It's into the path of Tesk. And Tesk could be on for the equaliser here. If he just took it a bit quicker, he maybe could have got the shot off. Now a major battle about 30 yards from the SCFC goal. It's Sam with long life south to Kwan. Determined loses out to Fourier, and now Fourier will try to get past, but Determined recovers brilliantly. Samu now, all the S20s on start. It's cleared by Freddy Big Harman, did well to get back. And that's a terrible tackle by Black. Could be a yellow card with his first tackle. No, it's just a warning from Sean. John places the ball and gets ready for Freddy to tackle it. And now Freddy booted up to the pitch. It's 4 years now, headed to Alfie on the right wing. He's got loads of space to go into, but he decides to take the first time pass. Was that a bad decision? I don't think so, where's Elias? And Elias sets himself up, but it's clear by Determined, excellent defence. Very big hard man now to Elias, who's onside. Ball in, everybody's missed it, but Alfie, 2-0. That's an excellent goal. And Alfie goes to celebrate with the fans. Huge mark of respect there to the loyal SCFC. And SCFC 2 up now, within 8 minutes. And Samuel gets the game back underway. It's back to Philip Neen now. He'll look to play a long ball over the top of two SCFC men. Headed back to Fourier. Alfie has a look at his options and decides. Oh, it's a bad foul by Ong. He did go for the ball. And now he gets a warning from Sean. And Alfie needs to be refreshed. Big ball of what we'll look to. Bounce it up the pitch. Play to Cigar at home. The rest goes to Lee Cheek. And 4 years steps over it. And it's the big, oh, that super play from SCFC. Good stickery there. 4 years in loads of space now. Can whip a perfect ball in. It's Xtino. It's saved. And now it's Xtino again. Oh, and it's picked up by the keeper. That was such a chance for SCFC. Bench has a goal. And it's easily seen. Over the top, looking for Tesk. Any big arm man should tidy up here. And it's back to the keeper. Nice and safe. It's big. And it's notable that SCFC are one of the only teams that can play back to the keeper and then to another centre back because of their pressing up the pitch and the skill that both centre back. Of course, playing on a neutral ground today, but SCFC Royals have still turned up. Now, there was a pass looking for Samu and Sigari. Big ball about now to Foyer. And Phil gets in front of him but can't get the ball out. It's gone out now. And it'll be, I think, Alfie to take the throw in. Yeah. For he looks to get back on the field, and it's small play by SCFC. Tess wins it back, and that's a terrible tackle by Alfie. Should have been a yellow, I feel, because it was quite a bad challenge. Well, good consistency by Sean, to be fair. Now, Shane Frost looks to take the free kick. It's up to Samu. We could go on a run here, and it's tackled by Very Big Arm Man. Excellent. Tess wins it back. Now, Shane Frost. Out to Samu. Oh, past one, but couldn't get the final ball. It's Elias now. So Elias running down. And it's out wide. It's an Alfie. He hit it from a long distance and it was just a... It was not a bad effort at all. To try that from that, you've got to try that from that distance, then you've got to have someone. I think Elias was onside at the time of the pass. It's for you. And Black intercepts perfectly. Test now. Over the top to Samu, and it's a big chance. Big can't tidy up. It's Samu now for 2-1, and he's made it 2-1. Guildley up straight back in. Guildley back in it with a Samu Frost goal. It was superb play, and big ball couldn't get it. The referee sounds the beep, and that was big ball balls out to Very Big Arm. And that's going out for the throw in. So XD, you know who is on side because it was a throw in. And I'll show you for us. Elias, that's a weak shot and it'll go straight into the hands of Connie. Boosted up the pitch, very short side. Back to David Langley to try a list keeper. And straight up to Alfie. Was marked there, so doing well to get the pass off. But he's in an offside position at the moment, he's gone back on side. Now it's Very Big Arm Man to Elias. Elias now. Back into four, yeah. And it's cleared brilliantly by Guildley. And now here's Samu, that's an over hit ball. Really should have done better. Tesco's going to keep pressuring Very Big Arm Man now until the end. That's back to the keeper. Boosted it up superbly. Keep talking for Sagari with that pass. But it's headed down now to Foyer. And Foyer in a load of space. Gives it to XD now, who could finish. And it's headed away by Black, that's superb defending. Could go out. It doesn't. And now XD now into it. I Philip Nemus follows Elias, and that could be a pen. It is. Sean Ruick has called the penalty. And Phil has been given a warning from the referee. Referee stands to be for the Lions to take it. And it's straight on the middle and it saves and it's in. The rebound is in. Connor wasn't paying attention. It isn't bad for it at all. That was a strange thing about it. But it bounced off him on the rebound thanks to the new collide ball. Well, it was just taken an auto dribble. But it bounced off him on the rebound and Elias was able to finish into the bottom leg. Superb from SCFC to win the penalty in the first. Now just 1 minute left of added time. It's Shea Frost. Into the path of Samu and Ollie. Ollie can't get to it. And it's probably going to be dealt with by Benny McCarman. Down to Elias, but Block intercepts. And that's a poor effort. Oh, it's got it! That is an absolutely superb goal. That is just... What's he done there? The keeper's had an absolute shocker. The trialist keeper has just had an absolute shocker. And you can see his teammate consoling him, that's really good to see. No worries, says Alfie, it's just a friendly. And you can only agree. Osami, yeah, score is 3-2 to FCFC. I feel unfazed, like when I'm with my friends with a cup raise. Hi. Hello. It's good to see this team is controlled with a bomb. Trust me, go hard. Yes, we go hard. You said we go hard. We just received news that Elias's Wi-Fi surgery went well. Expected to return in 2 minutes. I've got to say, the official has been very good from Sean Wilk and especially good Sammy with the offside calls. Even though every call has been onside. How much to call in this game apart from the penalty, but everything's been a warning so far, not a single card handed out, which you can't really complain about. If you rest, if you win friendlies. But Guildley got back in it when they were 2-0 down from a brilliant goal. And then SCFC took a 3-1 lead with a brilliant penalty from Elias. Stepped up, fires it straight at the keeper and got the rebound into the bottom left corner when Connor wasn't paying attention.
And to be fair,
they have been alright, but I feel like SCFC have just been getting too much space on the wings. They've been crossing it into XD, you know. But I feel that David Langley's actually been alright in goal. He thought it was going wide, he said, clean chat. But that stunner went in.
I think the thing that they did even better was the animation.
Yeah, that was the best thing about it. It's good to see his teammates console with him though. It's really unlucky.
Is he a trialist
though? You are, bruv. How are you feeling today, mate? You know what? I feel. He's a trialist at SCFC. He's their backup keeper, I think.
I Feel kind of cheeky myself. Shall we get you?
I'll show them real call with the people to get in positions. Six swaps.
Medium or cheeky Nando's. Paradise sauce. Cheeky Nando's. Boneless fries. Cheeky Nando's. Skinny cheese on. Cheeky Nando's. Two sides of my wings. Cheeky Nando's. Peri peri sauce. Cheeky Nando's. Out with the boys.
Cheeky Nando's. If it's not cheeky, you didn't go.
Gotta make sure it's a cheeky Nando's. Sit back.
It'll be SESC to take this half kick off.
Walk up to the till. Give me some nuts. Don't want a drink, but I'll take a cup. She said that's for water. Yeah, alright. I'm a cheeky lad, so I fill it with Sprite.
I go to Nando's, it's all popped off. Corn on the carb, it gets knocked off. When I draw for the olives, I go pop, pop, pop. Hot sauce goes to the top, top, top. My wallet's tight, my girl's knock, knock, knock.
It'll look like it'll be a dual kickoff between Elias and Foyer. Oh no, Elias stepped away. Referee sounds the beep and Foyer kicks us off for the second half. Is Big Ball aboard? Back to David Langley, early touching the second half for him. Teammates were a little nervous despite his ball playing ability as being alright. That's up to Foyer and tackled superbly. Not a pass back, it was a 50-50, but Connor kicks it away anyway.
It goes long to Very. Oh, it's been blocked there. Guildley can chase that one.
Elias now a bit of lag there. He can't even kick the ball because he's got the lead exclamation mark.
Elias' left-hand surgery has in fact not worked.
The amount of money SCFC played for it as well, and that's a terrible foul. Some advantage there. And the ref's trying to tell them that they played on, apparently. Well, they've got the ball now, so it doesn't matter.
Oh, Alfie,
that's a terrible challenge.
Fly tackle. However, it's well defended by someone who's jumping around.
And that was Elias' foul on Shade.
Right, I have no idea who's offside at any point now because
yellow card.
My line's not working. But that's unfortunate.
It's the first yellow card of the game, and apparently he lagged while he tackled him off the ball.
Put the free kick taken,
he's offside.
There's nowhere on earth he wasn't offside, but they may play advantage.
But it's played now by French. Brilliant advantage, but he can't take advantage of it. That's headed back by Philip Neen to the goalkeeper. And now David well being cheeky and waiting for it to go off for the goal. Goal kick taken short by David. Just a guy just outside the box. Nope.
Looks down the line to Dino.
Dino tries to cross inside in midfield, yeah.
Driving down the middle. Plays the ball back to, is that Very? I have no idea.
Big ball aboard. It's very big hard, man. And now up to Elias, who's on.
Got a man right on him though, and it's a good tackle. Out for throw in to SCFC. In a good area.
Could just launch it into the box here. There's a few men coming in. Three options in the middle. One slightly too far for the throw, I think. Yeah. 16, you know, can't get the touch on it.
Oh.
Phil tackled away. Sagari has a shot, and it's a foul by Ollie. It's a free kick for this. Yellow card showed to Ollie.
Slightly controversial decision there, as he did take the shot. Oh, there's going to be a drop ball, never mind then.
Going to be a drop ball because he got the decision wrong. Fair play by the referee.
Oh, that nearly went...
Back to the keeper, that nearly went...
That would have been one of the more interesting goals we've seen.
Especially after that David Langley mistake.
Yep.
And here he is now. Looking to play it. Oh, that's a terrible pass. And now it could be an equaliser for Guildley. Oh, that's a terrible challenge, and that's got to be a yellow card and a last warning.
Ollie not happy with the challenge.
Going to be a free kick around 22, 23 yards out.
Yep, this is all coming from the poor pass out from the keeper.
It'll be Ollie to step over it.
No,
if Ross takes the run up, Elias has gone a bit too far.
Look like it's going to be a shady, is it? To take it?
Ollie. Now Shade. Locked a bit into the wall.
And now Dino looks to counter. It's going to go out for a throw though. Yep. Oh, he's died.
Girls, we can now take advantage of this. Four men back with SCFC, including Xtino's now gone up to midfield.
Oh, is there a scramble going on out there? We just get it clear. Phil recovers possession for his team, but Alfie passes it to Dino, who can counter here. He's got a man.
Turns it up. 4 years on side.
Oh,
the defender's missed the tackle. Oh, you know, 2-1-1. Johnson is 3-4-2.
That's unfortunate for, for the keeper. Lags at the wrong time. He's AFK. Nope, just lagged at the wrong time.
So he takes a quick kick off. Elias was still in there half. And the referee calls for the retake because he didn't beep.
How many of the Guildley players actually play for them? And how many are on trialing?
For them, Guildley?
Yeah.
It's just not trialing for them, I don't think. It's just the team and on loan from Connor.
Wait, I'm going to check their squad sheet because...
Oh, it's Connor and Determined. I'm on loan for this match.
Ollie's also on the trial, isn't he?
Oh, no, he's not on a trial. He's just gone on loan for the friendly.
Oh, okay.
And that's a terrible tackle for now, and it could be a last one.
Slightly interesting attempt to tackle there from Tess.
Oh,
yeah. Alpha plays the ball quickly to Elias, who's in bags of space in the right wing.
Always receives a yellow card.
A good catch.
And that's
by
got like on it. Didn't want to get to the far post.
A very long ball played. Alfie should get there. Oh, he's kicked out.
A meme prince.
Well, you know what they say, if in doubt, get it out, but I mean, probably have better options, but never mind.
And Phil wants us to see the flow in, I believe, but Black took it anyway. It's
Tess
now.
Tries to go past Very, who gets in front of him. Can Tess keep it on? No, he kicks it off.
He just kicks it off.
Well, that's South Croydon school now.
Now where's Xtino?
And now French guys, it's completely thrown goal here.
As a one-on-one.
Can't take too long though. Now he's taking
it too wide. He's taking it way too wide. Well, the ball could set himself up for the strike now. Oh, so sorry, that's 4 years. Yeah, and that should be a penalty.
Yeah.
Shea Frost with a foul.
Second penalty of the game for South Croydon.
Yellow card for Shea Frost. And South Croydon have a chance to make it 5-3. I believe David. Yeah. David, the man who missed a penalty. the same as just try to completely.
Oh, oh, good turn when it's scored. Nice. That's what you want.
That was excellent.
It's one of the more interesting penalties I've had the pleasure of watching.
Just touched it.
Yep, dribbled about three times before taking the shot.
John Teddy was on the field, but about one.
Yeah. Who also misspelled Stephen Gerrard there.
Yeah. 46 to penalty. Oh. 46 to penalty now after the referee sounds the beep on his 4 yet to score. 5-2.
And it would have been a retake if he missed anyway because of encroachment in the area. I mean, it's not 6-2 at all, but eh, whatever. Referee's slightly struggling to put 4-1 together at the moment. Oh, no, not 6-3.
Some philosophy to keep it. 6-3, apparently.
So it's gone from 5-2 to 6-3.
And there we go. Eventually sorted out by the referee.
Defender trying to take on the player. Good ball.
Wow, with a terrible challenge, and that's going to be a free kick to SCFC. And then Ollie should follow them for the second time. And Ollie's on a ramp.
Ollie's on a mad one today.
He can't take a single friendly seriously.
As he goes over and headbutts Elias.
It's a Bernard headbutt. Tell you what, though, the Charleston got sent off for that against Bournemouth away. And it's just tried to take him.
You do get the sense Guildley have given up slightly.
And Tesco's been sent off.
Well, now down to how many plays did they start with? 6 or 7? Right. Yeah, now down to 6 men or 7. One of them. Who knows?
No, I see if you can finally get on with the game. That should be about 10 minutes as a timer, anyway.
Yeah.
Play quickly by Elias. I know it's big.
One of the worst.
Pumped away by
I've ever seen in my life, but never mind.
I'm sure if that's a corner kick or a throw in.
Looked like a throw in where I was well, flying.
Yeah, and it's quite far down the pitch as well.
It's
just gone on a mad run. And that's why he's still launching into the box, Ollie. He's clearly not taking this seriously.
He tries to launch himself into the box. And that's
big with the header. Oh, where is the keeper? How is he firing that wide?
No, it was going on target, but then the spin of the ball took it wide.
Very big old man now. That's a sensible tackle by Jay Frost. That's so late. That was going to be a free kick to SCFC. Sean's got a decision to make here.
Still slightly struggling to understand the rules at the moment. Well, I just realised, why are we playing at this stadium?
I've got no clue.
Surely it would make more sense to play at Old Depot, considering that's actually one of the home stadiums for one of the two teams playing.
Yeah, but it's a neutral ground, isn't it? You can't complain.
Fair enough. Well, for whatever reason...
And that's another terrible challenge. Nobody's taking
this seriously. Guys have a player in their own box, playing everyone on.
I think that was Black then. He just decided to step in to the 6 yard box. Now two people have been trapped by the wall. It's a very common occurrence.
You're meant to slide all time. I quote. The only thing you're meant to do in football is slide, apparently. There you go.
Yeah.
Right, Dino, take the free kick.
Oh, that's... Oh my God, how has that got in?
Both the goalkeeper and the defender on the line missed it.
This is terrible. 6-2 now to West FC.
If Gade only conceded 4.
And all he comments wasn't really a good goal when we own goal. But I think that was on target, so we should come for Dino.
Yeah, it was definitely on target.
Now meanwhile, everybody...
half of Guildley's team is now in the Taliban. Oh, yeah.
At the time, has been called just 4 minutes.
We'll just
the ads, and Philip Neem is keeping everybody on side.
Look at all these tackles going in.
It's a really vicious game here. We've got SCFC versus Guildley. And also Guardy plays it back to David Langley.
He plays it long to, there.
Well, it could be a goal, but he just decides not to shoot, and the keeper's about 30 yards out of his goal.
I think that's possibly the first dribble I've watched where there wasn't a slide tackle attempt.
Especially from Guildley.
Yeah.
And now for you, playing a part at the back, plays it back to David, who's under pressure now from Black. Takes his time with it and plays it safe.
Oh, very big hard man. Is that the goalkeeper?
The goalkeeper is about...
Oh, Dino's now got a completely open goal. Oh, and
he's being unselfish for some reason.
I don't know
he's onside.
Why they're not shooting, considering there is physically no keeper in goal. And they both missed it.
And that's a penalty because Sicardi's been fouled. Call an advantage, and that's definitely... He took about 10 seconds to call it, even though there was clearly no advantage, and he'd rather have a direct shot.
Yeah, even though the ball was physically going out the box to a Guildley player. Oh, and
he's being given a red card.
It will most likely go to 7-2 now.
Depends who's taking it.
Well, yeah. The goalkeeper's got naked on my screen. I don't know if that's for everyone.
Yeah.
Yep, okay, nice. Strip ECL. Every goal scored, you take off a layer of clothing. Meanwhile, SCFC have 3 players currently in the area, 2 now. Still 2.
And now for a big slide tackle to it into the bottom corner. That's an excellent penalty.
Slightly questionable keeping, I would say, but
yeah, it didn't have a lot of pace on it.
No, or direction. It just pretty much, it wasn't even bottom corner. It was like halfway between the middle and the bottom corner.
Now we see the SCFC Ultras.
Yep.
You've got Sam Devs, Jack Brownie, and attempted celebrating the goal like absolute mad lads with 3 pyros. And Morgan Murphy just wandering around the stadium. It's a big place just for a max 20 people. Make sure you do, you'd rather have something like the Fortress where there's one stands and about 40 seats.
Wow, look at all these.
Just wants to throw it up the stand.
Absolute ultras. One of them has a completely default Roblox, what's it called? Body? Skin? I don't know. Avatar? Sure, we'll go with that. Alright, I'm not actually watching the game. Here we go.
I thought the game would just side tackle someone. I don't know what's going on there.
This game has ever so slightly gone to shit, but never mind.
Yeah.
There's a dead player in the corner. Oh, that's a fan. Or is that an official? I have no idea. Looks like a fan.
Both subs. What's happened there?
I have no idea.
Oh, it's a corner kick, apparently. This is the last attack. Oh, that's full time. 7-2 to the SCSC. I don't believe that.
What an ending to the match.
Can we pay attention to the fact that this was a 3-2 at one point?
Ah, well.
Who was that? I want that autograph now, because he just backwards it out.
Everyone's just killing everyone at the moment.
Yeah, I spawned the ball just to make it a bit spicy.
Go for it. I'll spawn a few more.
Here we go. And now, next shot, the gamer gets the first foul.
Those two players are flying into the crowd.
It's a superb goal, and another one that's just P-rolled across the line. And now there's a ton of fouls. Samu fouls Xdino, I Shady fouls assisted scored. What? Officials hit it out, apparently. Entertainment has just hit that out.
Right, I'm going to team myself, team one, and join in with this, right?
Let's go. Nobody can stop Connie. He's just on a map. He's finally died. Oh.
Oh, I've been stabbed. It's like Liverpool versus Rome all over again.
Oh. No, that was a great rendition of Zed Cars.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, from everyone at Channel 5 Football, we say good night from the the South of Rangers Stadium, also known as the Prince Malcolm. That's the Prince Malcolm, really. Right.
Right, it's just the stream done now. But yeah, for me. Meanwhile, the timer is on 1,154.
That's how many seconds it's been. Looks like everybody's being given a sword in their throat, and now there's just mass murder on the pitch. That kill always worked a great effect.
Thank you. Oh, I've got a sword now. I don't believe there's a sword fighting tournament. I'm going to be sick of this.
I might just...